study, we are talking about the refuge, refuge prayer, then with the cha, fastation. So today we will talk about the bodhicitta. So actually in the preliminary practice, then we are saying this is the 500,000 course. So 500,000 course means first one is the refuge with the first station, that is the one. Then second is recitation of the bodhicitta. Then third is then doing the vajrasattva practice. Then fourth is then mandala practice. Then fifth is guru yoga. So each one is, you know, 100,000, 100,000, 100,000, then it's become 500,000 course. Bumnga in Tibetan used to say. Oh, you done bumnga? Means you done the preliminary practice? You finish your bumnga? Like this they will say, bumnga. But here, so Dzogchen Rinpoche met very short, as short as possible for us. So we have very short time, therefore Rinpoche know that. And then he met this is possible, you to do the refuge and the bodhicitta together. So it's become bumsi. 100,000 is given excuse. So, in the visualization, when you do the prostration and reciting the, refuge sadhanas from mouth and acting your body as doing the prostration, at that time, then in front of visualization on the your refuge tree, then there is your root guru in form of the Padmasambhava. Like this, as we talk. Now you people know how to do the visualization of that. And bodhicitta prayer, this, sadhana time, the visualization is the same as it is. It remains as it is. There is the, refuge tree, and there is the snowland throne, and on the throne lotus, and then sun, moon, disk, and then on that your root guru in the form of the lotus-born Padmasambhava. Lotus-born Vajra Padmasambhava is there. And in front of him, you are doing promise. That time you think that is the, you are doing promise, therefore this is witness for you. Same refuge tree is witness for you. Then in the short prayer, then there is Dhani Sundi Korwa Madongbar Maju Semjin Kunji Pende Trup, like this word is coming. So everybody have that one, Mundo. Mundo is a book, not a. Yeah, Refuge is saying here, you know, just this one is the refuge prayer. There is only two lengths. Huh? Mm-hmm. So we are trying to finish the four lengths, each, you know, chap, each first station, then four lengths. Half is refuge, half is bodhicitta. Even then, first, during the first station, three times you have to think and you have to say, Dizung Changchup Nimbu Mato Parlama Konjo Sumla Kyapsu Chi. That is, you are doing the first station and you are paying your devotion to the Buddha Dharma Sangha, to the three roots, to the three kayas. Then, after that, this one we have to join together. Then, Tane Sungde Korwa Matong Par Majur Semjin Kunji Pende Tup. From now, then this onward, Tane Sungde Korwa Matong Par, until the samsara is finished. Then, Majur, all the living beings who are once my mother, Semjin, all the beings, Kunji Pende Tup, for all, I am doing the benefit. Huh? I am benefiting for all the sentient beings until the samsara is become empty. I like to benefit. So that time, then you think in front of the your refuge tree, you are doing the promise, and that will be the witness. So slowly, past the season, beginning time, three times you should think like this. Then after this, then just repeat and going each four lane, then one first station, and then continues on that, you know. No need to see again and then repeat it, or then saying this. Then again to see, then there is no time. So first three times like this, very careful, and then just continues that one. Until you try it. Then, when you try it, then you have to sit up. So, after this, then the visualization is the same. Same, but your motivation has to change. That first two land is you are paying your devotion to the refuge tree. And that next two land is you are promising in front of the your refuge tree. Refuge tree is given as the witness, as the judge. Then you are the criminal. Then you are saying truth in front of there. From today's onward, until the samsara is become empty, I am working for benefiting for all these living beings who are once my mother. So you are talking. So, bodhicitta, just two words, saying bodhicitta, then we say, oh, compassion, like this thing, sometimes related to bodhicitta is compassion. It is giving right meaning? For the Changchup Sam, bodhicitta is compassion. So compassion, then also there is no two words, one compassion. So very easy, but then you should think the meaning of the compassion. What is compassion? To do the, you know, some kitty or dog is there, then you say, is that is enough compassion? I don't think. And some people are falling down. You give the hand, just stand up. That is enough compassion. So, biggest compassion is we think ourselves how much I am suffering in this world. What evil worldly work is doing, this has no end. So, just roaming in this one. So these worlds, all the content, all connection with these worldly things, it is, you know, making, we like to have the peaceful, but all the our activities making sins and non-virtues, then fruit of the non-virtue and the sins, then what is bringing? Then bringing again more suffering. So thinking like this, then everybody like the happy and peaceful. Nobody like painful and difficulty. So that is the same, but method is not knowing. We are foolish, therefore we are not knowing the method to making party, very happy party. Then we are killing the chickens, and then cutting this, buying the meat. So that very meat also has the life. One time it is alive. Lifetime this meat has the me. There is me in that meat. So they are not, their life is not free. They have scare and they are carrying their life as we are holding our life precious. They are thinking their life precious. But then we think, oh, we are doing enjoy. That is forget. That is nothing. Oh, this is for the eating. Okay. Then purpose of the keeping ox like this, ox or bulls, keeping and the grass and the grassing and just serving for this very nice, for the meat to kill. So like these things, goats, sheep. So all things which we think this is enjoy, so that enjoy's root is sin. So that sin result is giving us more suffer. Then we kill the animal. Then next time, then we taking the, as we are Buddhism, we have to believe rebirth. We will take same death, and they will take our place. Then they will kill us. Then it goes to samsara's wheel. Wheel will go like this. So karma is there. So to get through this, so how many care you have for yourself? Like here, there is one pimple. So just one pimple, then putting little, some medicines to remove this. Ourselves is like this. Everybody is like this. If they will see their self, they have this, little pain, then just eating some medicine. So everybody dislike same. So thinking this, and then they don't know how to cure from this, then better to have no birth. So no birth is not only the, birth control. It will never help. So I dislike to take the rebirth. So what I have to do? Liberate from this samsara. And all my friends, all the peoples, they dislike the suffering. So they have to liberate. So I like to help all the living beings. So according to my capacity is not enough to help all the people. So all the living beings. How I will help? So first I must get myself into the enlightenment. Then I really promise that I will help. So that is the first stage. There is three stages of the doing, bodhicitta. So that is the, lowest capacity is bodhicitta. Is that? I must do practice, I must get the enlightenment, then I will help all. Like this. So that is called like the king. The bodhicitta like the king. King bodhicitta. So first you like to become the king, then you are going to serving for your subject. That is the lowest capacity. That's capacity. Then middle one, then middle one is saying, oh, I like to do the sacred, you know, tantric practice, which has more energy, more difficulty, more shortcut. I will do this, and me and all the living being at the same time must get the liberated from there. All. Same time. So that is middle capacity. That is called the bodhicitta, like the boatman. So boatman, then passenger and the sailor men, they are getting same time that side of the river, together. So like to take together. So this is the middle capacities. So highest capacity bodhicitta is saying shepherd. So shepherd never walking before the sheep. And shepherd is just walking after the sheep, flock of the sheep, after this. And one is left, again he will run and he will beat. It is making to go forward. No is remain, backside. So he is the final one. So you think, this practice, this prayer, this sadhana, this offering, what I am doing, this is for benefit for all the sentient beings who are once my mother. Now they are become foolish, innocent. They like to have the happy and peaceful, but instead of making this, then they have no knowledge, therefore they are working for wrong view, and again they are going to drown in this samsara for the more suffering. So I like to save all this first. So that is the highest capacity. So that is called shepherd. So there is bodhicitta, thought has the three kind of the thought. So highest capacity is like the example, and the name is called shepherd. Then second is called boatman. Then third lowest capacity is called king. So among these three, you have to choose which capacity you are. So mostly all the Mahayana, Tantric, then this, you know, Vajrayana, high Tantric, these practitioners all are saying, oh, I will be the last one, you know. I must be the, you know, shepherd one. So therefore, all the lineage head lamas, they are just, you know, there is argue. So we are saying all this samsara is finished, then final Buddha, who is the final Buddha? After all, last Buddha. Then last Buddha's name is Mevatthaye, this kalpa. So we are saying, for praying Dinjum Rinpoche, all the Nyingma Pasa is saying, Mahong Sangye Mevatthaye Shab. The Dinjum Rinpoche, who is going, last Buddha, Mevatthaye. So Nyingma Pasa believe Dinjum Rinpoche is going, last Buddha. He is coming. After all we send, then he is coming. So he is the Buddha, last Buddha. Then Kajipa, they are saying, oh, Karmapa is the last Buddha. Then Sajapa, they say, oh, Sajja Tenzin is the last Buddha. Then Gelugpa, they are saying, oh, Yongzin Chichang, Dorje Chang, he will be the last Buddha. So we pray, I must be the last Buddha. I like to liberate all. All samsara become empty, then I will go. Then I am satisfied, then I will go. So bodhicitta, there is, you know, three bodhicittas like this. So then first we should check ourselves. We have Buddha essence, then where is our bodhicitta? We have bodhicitta. How much care we are giving our this corpse, this dead body, this clay, this corpse. If this is, you know, hot, then just put on. This is cold, wrapped up. This is hungry, you eat. This is thirsty, you drink. We are giving very sympathetic, or what do you say, very care for on. And then we have, you know, bodhicitta, because you like your child, you like your parent, you like your, you know, family, you like your village, like this. There is bodhicitta. But there is bodhicitta, we have bodhicitta's seat, but our bodhicitta is become, you know, partiality, big partiality. How much compassion I have to my child, that much I never have for the other's child. That is become partiality. So to increase the bodhicitta, you try to make this your love, or this your, you know, compassion, or whatever you have. As you are caring your child, you should care the all the living beings in front of you. Then you check it is going right or wrong. How many kindness or love you have to your child, and then you put your enemy there, worse enemy, for the example. Then try to share your compassion to your enemy. Then you check which compassion I am giving to my son, my daughter. This much I am giving to my enemy. Now, which is same or is different? You will check, there is different. When you found there is different, so this your bodhicitta is not, you have no, you know, authority that say, I am bodhicitta, I am bodhisattva. Then no authority, because now in the nut of the your ignorance has bended inside your bodhicitta is. So how we will do the compassion to, how we will share our love, compassion to the, you know, in me. So like the bodhisattva, that is also the, you know, bodhisattva, we are saying Changchub Sampa Tadu Ngu. So who is always crying, crying bodhisattva. So crying bodhisattva, he looked all the samsara's, you know, activity. Really he felt very sorry. Then he cried. Then this cry never stop through his life. He saw really suffering. So he's just crying. So in his life, only 2 times he smelled. Smelling, what is this? Yeah, he's smelling. 2 times only. So 1 time then he is in the Patana. In the ancient letter, it is a Pataliputra, but now it is Patana in Bihar, in India, where Acharya Raj Nishi is, you know, headquarter. So that is the Patana. So he is sitting there, you know, near one village. Then there is a big field. Near the field, there's a tree. So he's sitting under the tree and just crying and sitting there and thinking about the sadness of this world. And he's crying and sitting. So early in the morning, one man who is, you know, a farmer, he came with the two bull, and he is just pulo is hanging, and he came and he started to work early in the morning to blowing the, you know, land. He's working. Then he's looking all these samsaras, you know, suffering. These all are, you know, he's looking. No meaning. He found no meaning like this. He's just keeping looking and crying, sitting there. Then when the sun shines, then the lady, his wife, is coming to bring the breakfast, to give him breakfast. So she has putting something on her head, and she's holding one child here, and she's coming. When she came there, and he stopped to plow, and he came towards her, and he just took the child, and just kissing, and giving pet, and then he's sitting there. And after this lady, one dog is also coming, following, one hungry dog is coming. And the dog is just sitting there, and then she opened the food. Then there is few bread and then fish. And then he started to eating the fish, and he is giving for his child. Child he is feeding, and he is eating, and he is looking this dog. Dog is hungry and looking there and smelling this fish. So looking there, and he is very angry. As he is throwing something there, reading out the dog. So, Changju Sambatak Ngu, that Bodhisattva, he is just looking all this. Then the fish, that fish which he is eating, is the tulgu of he is a father. His father is dead, and the father's tulgu is fish. And that fish was got killed and bring here, now he's eating. And the dog, which he tried to get out, is a tulgu, his mother's tulgu. He is only these lives, father, mother, dead, and they took the life. That hungry dog is his mother. So there he's holding one, is his previous life's words in me, who killed him. That in me is holding here. So then he think all this, and he saw all this drama. then he smell, what a wonderful world. Eating father and drawing mother. How bad this one, giving love for the in me. This is the world. Then he smell. Smelling. So like this case, we don't know. So like this. So also there is some, you know, Drukpa Kundi says, oh, maybe Dharmadhoti is the Marpa's son. Maybe this is really son. Other mostly these child are the parents, you know, lencha. Lencha means you done some bad things for them, then they came to again to take your revenge, then they become your child. And then child, then whatever child wish you have to offer. So like the lice, so some lice is sitting on your head and eating there, and you feel uncomfortable taking out, just killed there. You killed, and he has no capacity to drink one drop of your blood. Not that much stomach he have. Very little he like to have. But your compassion is, you know, that eating you dislike and you killed. He went alive. now life is end. Then he liked to have something from you, and you killed him. So this one then become your son. Then you have to offer everything, your property, your life, and then rid out all the dirty thing in the small time. Then no difficulty to serving on child, no difficulty. That very child is the tulku of your life, which you killed. Again he came to take the revenge. So samsara movement goes like that. So thinking like this, then we don't know who is really my friend and who is really in me. In this short life, we will see many worse enemy will help you best when you got the difficulty. He is the best helper for you. That is possible. The best friend for whom you are given full faith, full confidence, he will shoot you. Like the Prime Minister of India, which lady they called Indira Gandhi. So she was shot down by her, bodyguard. Suppose his duty is to shoot the other who pointing to her, but he shoot her, then what is there? So, like these things. So you think all these things, then that your personality mind is going to broke in pieces. Why I care too much, only my child? Everybody is the same. Why I am so angry on this man, and I think this is my enemy? This must be the my father passed, my life. This is the my father who paid me too much, who served me, who cared me. This is my mother. I drink his, milk. This man's milk I drink when he is my mother. So today, what happened? So due to the ignorance, they are thinking, me, I am here, then you are, then become dualism mind's manifestation. Then good, bad, then everything start. So all this you have to experience, you have to think. Then really you are this, boundary of the limit or boundary of the your compassion is going to open. So first you should try, I will try to help all my neighbor as much as I could. I will help all the neighbor. So then after this, all this, my area, then all this my turn. Then after all this state, then you should try if the mind balance is going right, you are sure. At one time, somebody will say, you must have the great compassion for six realms, your teacher will say. Then you say, yeah. I have to share my compassion for the six realms. That can't work. They're saying only is not working. Listening is not working. Do right practice, practical things. So best thing, best easy and thing is in the merit doing like the self-practice. When you do the practice, short practice, long practice, whatever you are doing, some spiritual, then you should think, I am doing this to get some energy. So understanding. So that energy must help all the living beings. All the living beings must have this. So we are praying as Buddhism's praying in front of the Buddha's statue. Please, Lord, save all the living beings from this samsara suffering. That is the Mahayana Buddhism's practice. When you offer on the, you know, Jambala statue or the Vasudharani statue, you are offering waters. That is the wealth deity. Hmm? So offering, at that time, you are offering water and your motivation is, please, you please kill this poverty all over this samsara. Poverty, hmm? Poverty means poorness. Poverty, you must clean up the poverty of this samsara. You must, you know, clean up, purify this, you know, poverty of the over this world. Even then that is a big, you know, big mind. Big mind is called the bodhicitta. That is bodhicitta's way. And pouring water, I must gain the lottery, I must win, I must become rich, then it can't work. Hmm? So in the Hinduism, then it will work. Hmm? Because their object for whom they are doing the sadhana puja, the object itself is in the samsara. Therefore, then it is easy to request. Huh? Ganesh, then you are offered the, you know, butter lamp, then you say, oh Ganesh, today you must help me. I have a big business. If this business is went on the right, then tomorrow I will offer you the, you know, pure geese lamp. Okay? That Hinduism they used to say. Yeah, really, it is not a joke. Then when they are sick, then they are saying, oh, please, save this one, you know, my this one save. So that is become also no bodhicittas. That is very big partiality mind. Even our child is sick and we are, you know, very difficulty because we are living being, we are not a, you know, wisdom one. So we are carrying this, oh, this is now what I have to do. Then we are doing some prayers. At that time, you have to think, at that time, at that moment, how many people, same disease is suffering in this world. All must get, you know, free from this suffering. Then you do the, you know, some puja. Then really it will help him. Hmm? By the motivation, only this one particular, then it will help. It will help because this is the dharma words. It will help, but very little. Hmm? Then you think, oh, all like this pen. If you have some pen, then you are doing some to read out this. Hmm? Read out your pen, then you are doing the mantra recitation. Huh? So I dislike this, you know. So this go away, you are doing. So that is not much helping. Same this disease, how many people are in this world only? Or you can say in the United States, same this pain, how many people are suffering now? Or moreover, our in this world, then how many people are suffering? Same case. So all dislike, all are suffering like me. So please, I am praying this mantra to rid out this disease from the world. So all must care. Then you recite, then it will affect more. Hmm? So bodhicitta means like this, it will work. So without bodhicitta and mind, you know, motivation, if we don't make up our motivation, we will play on our ignorant mind, then it is very difficulty. Then we are just offering for the dharmapala, like that one small gablet, which is called sergem. Hmm? So Sergeyim, this much Sergeyim. And then we are saying, this, what is this? Oh, this is for the Dharma protectors. And we, like me, one man can drink this much tea or wine. Then that Mahakala will satisfy this much only. Huh? That will be going to disappear in his mouth. No? Then not only Mahakala, then many, many deities. So how to increase more? So everything is, you know, there is a way how to use this. So like these things. So we have to making our mind capacity to hold more. So we think, you know, instantly somebody is saying bad word in front of you and you dislike, you become very angry. At that moment, then if you have the, you know, some practice, then you are able to wear that for the moment. That is called the passion. You do the passion for 2 minutes. The man's anger will go down. Then you can talk. There is nothing. So like this thing, Milarepa's song, they says, you know, oh, thank you for the my enemies. If enemies are not giving me suffering, then I am not going enlightenment. So thank you for the ankle. He says, he got too much difficulty from the ankle. So, like this, you know. So we can try to use the 6 paramitas. Six paramitas we try to use according to the samkhya. How to increasing your, you know, bodhicitta, how to develop the bodhicitta. That duty is 6 paramitas. And to set up the, you know, bodhicitta, then partiality, like these things are the enemy. Then you should think how it is coming. Partiality, then measure, like these things, all these things are coming again and again to destroy your capacity. So one time, that 15th Karmapa, so he gave the, you know, black crown ceremony, and afterward, then Rinpoche is laughing too much. Laughing. Then other his attendants said, what happened to Rinpoche? You're laughing too much. And he says, oh, maybe you have not seen this, our sponsor. Sponsor is Gaga-san. Gaga-san is the very, you know, rich people in the Central Tibetan. Like Indian Tata Birla, and they, here we say Bill Gates or something, big company. So like this man. So Karmapa is looking by his wisdom eyes. Then first this father is thought, today I must offer, you know, my best horse. So he went around the horse, where he put in the horse side. And then one old man is following that father, that old man, Reggie, all dresses Reggie, one old man is just hanging with him. And he's looking there. And this man is just guiding him. So that is Yita, Sarah, we say, Sarah or the measure or hungry ghost. Something is hanging with him. Then he turned his mind, oh no, Karmapa has the enough, you know. everybody is in pain. Why I will give my best horse for him? Maybe I will give one yak, good yak. So he went towards the yak side. Again, this old man is company with him. There's no old man, but his thought or the energy. So Karmapa is looking. Then he tried to figure a best yak for the Karmapa. But this old man has taken away him. Then he turned his mind. Oh, that is not good. Then he's looking. Then finally he got one sheep. Then among the sheep, then first he's looking good sheep. Then afterward he looked, then he think, oh, this is the old sheep. This is nearly to die one. Better to give this to offer. Then he offered this to Karmapa. Then Karmapa know all this history and he's laughing. Laughing there. So like this, Sarak, Yida, all these are coming. Disturbances. So you should try to increase your, you know, six paramita accordingly you have to do. So that is the duty to increasing the bodhicitta. Dizun chanju nyungbu mato pa lama konjo sumla kyabsu chi, that is the, you know, refuge. Then dhane sunde korwa madong par majur semjeng kunje pende trup. That term is the, you know, for the bodhicitta. Te chanju di semla lo che. So here in the small letter it is says, you know, like this, then you have to try to accomplish the yourself into the bodhicitta, to increase the bodhicitta. So to increase the bodhicitta is like that. I told you, know, first you have compassion for yourself, you have compassion for your child. Your love is for the child, your family, like this. So you should try to increase this, you know, bigger, 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 bigger for all the peoples, for all the living beings. Then afterward, then it is first, you know, all your, you know, around area. Then you can, this city, then you will do the this, you know, district. So then after, then you do all the United States. Then it is going okay. Then you do all the world is same. Same compassion you share all the world. Then it is okay. Then you try to share the your compassion to the, you know, six realms. Then it will go easy. First you try to cover the six realms at one time. It is not going because it is stuck with your family. Or something. Okay, so after this, when you will done the 100,000 first station, then beside this first station, then 100,000 of the reciting the refuge prayer is finished, and also the bodhicitta prayer is finished. Two is going to finish. Then next is the, here it comes the mandala. So mandala is the great thing to increasing the your merit. So merit, then there is, we are thinking, there is what virtue. Then there is two kind of the virtue. One is merit virtue, one is wisdom virtue. Virtue, two virtues. So two virtues is important until you getting the understanding of the no birth. Jeva meba. If no birth, then there is no name of the death. If there is birth, then there is death. So all the dharma periods, then you know, aspiration periods, then there is saying, oh please blessing me to not birth. I must have the stage where is no birth, then no death. When birth is there, then we are doing same time. When we give the birth, at the same time, then we birth the death is coming. Puchyava meva madhopar. So up to that, when you will got the full understanding of the no generation. No generation, then no accomplishment. It will go up to this. So up to that understanding, what we need, the way. Way or the our helper is the virtue. Virtue is like the your vehicle's wheel, chariot. The Nagarjuna has put in that, you know, same example. So chariot has the two wheels. So he said these two wheels is the virtue. You think that two wheels of your chariot is virtue, two different virtues. Merit virtue and wisdom virtue. This you need to get the your palace. So that palace is the enlightenment, he says. So we are offering cho, we are offering butter lamb, we are offering mandala for the our teachers. And we are offering like these things, and offering incense, whatever, offering flower, like these things. Why we are offering? To get the virtue. For getting virtue purpose, these are offering. So then here, Padmasambhava, the Tantric founder, he said, there is the way, method. You should engage from your mind has the full energy. You should engage. Oh, this all samsara is my. My mind is covered all this. Samsara is my. So I like to offer this to the Buddha. Really you will think that then the result will be the very big one. You are getting. Really, you are offering loyi langde. Loyi langde means from the mind. Not that, oh, this is not my, but this, if I will offer, it is not going. So, it will remain as it is. So, I will just I make up to offer, then I will get the virtue, then never getting. You should engage from your mind, Mount Sumeru, and four direction continents. Then all the samsaras, you know, all the precious things, all are collected and then offered. So then it has meaning to getting your virtuous energy is very high, it will go. So therefore, then you have to think here in the world, here says, you know, Tserap Kunji Luitang Longju Pal Tsonyi Zocher Konjo Sumla Bull. For whom you are offering is offering to the Padmasambhava, form of the Padmasambhava, and Nature is your root guru, who he is a container of Buddha Dharma Sangha. So you are paying for one person, and it is getting to the three levels. So mandala, when you do the mandala, then you need the mandalas, this ball of the mandala, and it must be the clean and neat. Actually, we need, you know, each people need the two mandala sets, or one mandala set and then two, this lower plate. One is to play, another is to offering on the yashrin. Then rice, like these seeds, you have to, you know, make very clean, and then also you color with the saffrons. And if possible, that, you know, best seed is like the barley, white barley, if you found, then white barley, then we will make clean, and then saffron water, we will make the color yellow, like this. That will be, duration is long. Rice, then we will making wet, and then color with the saffron water. Then afterward, then we have to play. When we play this, then all are going pieces. Then afterward, it is going like the powder, then it is not comfortable. So barley is strong, like these things.
Might want to show them what these pans.
Yeah, you said.
The bases. The
various ones. Yeah. So one all the set you have to place on your shrine. On the shrine you have to place. Then one side must be another plate, and you put there. And there is a long sadhana. Then long sadhana here, it is not written. So if you found some lama or your friend who knows to read the long sadhana, then Om Benzarpumi Ahung, that will go from there. Then each has the meaning. Each has, we have to put in this, our feeling. Then after this full, then we will put this one. Then again, these are filling. Then we put this one. Then all are in the, you know, full. Then last the panel, then on the stop, then we will put this. Then we will offer this on the our shrine. So that is called the, you know, 37 times you have done the offerings. 37 different things. That mandala is for the offering. Then playing time, then we need only this one. Then there's only two words you have to chant. Serap kunje luda longje ba choni choje konjo sumdam bul. At that time, past your motivation and visualization, you have to think from today. Then there is the, you know, my refuge tree. There is the, you know, Padmasambhava's form. That is the my root guru, and is content all the Buddha Dharma Sangha, and also the, you know, three roots and three kayas, everything is content there. So in front of this, now I am offering. What is offering is my many lives, you know, many life and lives. Charap kunji luidang longje pal. So how much I have the wealth, and how much I have the property, and my body, belonging, property, everything is. All the glorious thing, all the valuable things are collected here, and I am going to offer this to the Buddha Dharma Sangha. Buddha Dharma Sangha's container, that is the, you know, Lord Padmasambhava in front of you, and who's, you know, nature is your root guru. So I'm offering this for there. So you think your lu, longju, your body and belonging, everything is offering today. So from the mind, you have to offer. And you don't think again, backward, you know. Oh, from the mind I offer, really I dislike to offer. You will think this, then all thing is when it finish. Again, it become zero. Huh? You think really I am offering, really I am offering. At that time, your work is going up, virtue is going up. You will think, oh, I'm just, you know, just offering, not really offering. Then it will go, I don't know. So, careful that time. And again, really I am offering. Really there is the, you know, refugee tree, and really there is all the nine energy is there, and I am offering my body and all my belonging and all my virtue, even what I have the virtue, I am offering for the Buddha Dharma Sangha, so that you know, to liberate all the, you know, samsara, and must get this virtue. When I offer this, then I am getting something, you know, blessing, blessing to, you know, purifying the our obscuration, and to purifying the our dualism mind into the wisdom, so that we must have this result, must have for all the living being, not only your head. You will say, I am offering this, all I collected, I am offering Buddha Dharma Sangha for you. Make me Buddha, make me teacher. Then it can't work. So this virtue must have. Please give the virtue for all the living being. I am offering this one for you. And you bless, please, you accept this and give the blessing for all the living being. That you try until you will get the, you know, how you say, this habitual. Then when it become habitual, then no makeup. Then it will go real. It is that. So that is careful. So here then we have to making, you know, just first we are holding like this, and we will take this rice. And to putting this rice, and then with the rice, then you can allow to put the different beads, small precious beads, citrons like this, you are allowed to mix, but all must wash and then clean it. Then when you play this, you know, to putting all these things together, then you have to make one cloth like the pere, like the square one, red, and then red one, then corner you have to put the blue, small blue. Then I use it. Like this. There's four corners, three corners you put like this, and not this thing, and one corner you put the string, so that it, when you finish, then you just tight in there, and then you put where the you can't go jumping on that. So text and all these puja instruments where you are putting, then is not actually, it is not allowed to put on the ground or to put on the mattress. That is not good. It must put some high place like these things. So when you will offer, then you are just taking this, and then this cloth just put on your there, you know, front all. Then there is the rice. Then you pick up the rice, and you have to place first one during the puja, and just placing first one is in the middle. So that symbols the, you know, first one you put here. This is the center, Mount Sumeru. Then you put in front of your there. This is the east world. This is the south world. Then this is the, you know, west. This is the north world. For different worlds with the Mount Sumeru. Then there is one. You put this side one. This is the sun. This is the moon. So it becomes seven. Then you just wave up by this your arms. just wave up. Then again, you play. 1, 2, 3, 4. This, you know, 5. Then there's 1, 6, 7. Then you do like this. So before this starting, you must have the some saffron water with you, so that you know you have to take from this finger saffron water, and you have to spring on this, and then again whip like this, by the hand. Then again you put like this, spring. Then you do like this 3 times. 3 times out, 3 times in. Then you little spring, then you put. Then you start to play that, you know, all these rice or beads. Then you have to count. So that is the mandala. Mandala is in the short way. In the very short way, how you will make the big virtue. Therefore, this mandala is made. Only 2 lines. So mandala is very important. What is the importance of the mandala? Like this thing, then moreover, if you like to learn, then you can learn from the Tsongkhapa biography. So Tsongkhapa is the founder of the Gelugpa sect. So Tsongkhapa, he is from the Amdo. So in his lifetime, he is not rich. He is a very poor man and monk. And he is very learned. And his whole life is, his practice is mandala. So he done mandala, and he have not like this copper. And nothing, this, you know, rice like this thing, even he's a beggar, he have nothing. So he used to hold the, you know, stone plate, some plate stone, and also white stone, he smash small, small pieces, that is working, and he's doing like this. So all this finished. Once he saw his boon, like this, he played the mandala. So all is in his biography, like this. So he says, by this practice, so then who is my follower, they never going dying with the hungry and thirsty, he says. Why means I offered, you know, mandala too much. So this virtue is more than enough, you know. So who is in his lineage, they never getting big difficulty about the living. So he says like this. So there is many about the mandala's talk, many good talks in his biography. So he is the one who he done whole life mandala, Tsongkhapa. So, first is, you know, we went from the first station and then the refuge, 100,000. To make yourself is a real Buddhism, perfect Buddhism, perfect Buddha's teaching, lineage holder. Therefore, then you done the Kyamdo. 100,000 times. Then to become the, in the Buddhism, to become the Mahayana Buddhism, to become the Bodhisattva stage, then you done the Semki, Bodhicitta, 100,000. Perfect Bodhisattva stage, perfect, you know, to become the perfect Mahayana. Then you done the 100,000 bodhicittas practice. Then you become Buddhism, pure Buddhism. You become pure Mahayana Buddhism. Now you are checking yourself, what is less in you. Then you found virtue is less. Because many, many lives we came to drink all non-virtues. So that is true. There is a very big non-virtue with us, but a very little virtue is with us. So even then you will think, oh, I done many big virtues. I never remember that I done non-virtue. But then you are not hiding yourself. Then you sit one corner and you think 5 minutes today, from morning to the, you know, morning 6 o'clock to this, now 6 o'clock. What virtues I have done and what non-virtues I have done, you should check yourself within 5 minutes, then you will know. Then that is example. Then 1 year, then you divide this into the 1 year, then how much virtue you done, how much non-virtue you done. Then you count your age, how many old you are. So how much virtue you done, how much non-virtue you done. So then we will find, oh, really, this virtue is just, you know, I done part-time little virtue. Rest all time I am on the duty of samsara. So all non-virtue. Then you will find like this. So we need the virtue. If there is no virtue, then we will try to do the something, good things, then it is not going on the right way. Without virtue, then they are making some, oh, I like to do the retreat, then building some cabin by the help of other self has no, you know, virtue, then others help, they making the cabin something for retreat. After full complete and it was got born. Like this happening. Because there's no much virtue to digest. What do you say? Digestion?
Digest.
Yeah, to digest. No inner of the digest. Then it will become, you know, help is become not help. So like this thing happening. So we need the virtue to do the dharma practice. So to making the virtue, to proving the virtue, then best way is the mandala. So this need only little time to doing that, you know, offering time, and yourself you have to keep in the attention. That is the little difficulty for us, and no expenses, nothing. You are 1 kg, you know, rice or barley will be remaining for 1 month. It is not going to finish. When you bought 1 pellet, it will be lasting for your life. Then it is not no costly one, but time is a little cost. Then time we have to give the time. If we have interesting to knowing the, you know, right dharma, then we must spend the time. Then many people saying, oh, we are too busy, this much practice, I have no time. Then better to not do. Who force you to do? We are showing that, you know, oh, If you will do this, you will getting the understanding. If you get the understanding, then you will knowing the path of the liberation. If you know the right path of the liberation, you will be become very, you know, important for all the living beings. So all the living beings has going to getting some, you know, light in their darkness. So therefore, so that is very important. So that to getting enlightenment, to doing practice, to accomplishment, that is very important. That is the our life's, you know, what do you say? Purpose. So many people are coming to me and saying, oh, what is my life purpose? Check in mirror. Then life purpose is death or what? Actually, life purpose is to do benefit to other and to get the enlightenment. This is the only chance. You have perfect body, you have perfect understanding, you have time. Then you should do, you should give the time, energy, you should spend, you should try to get the enlightenment. So that is your life purpose. But that is not, that is just all the practice, everything is, you know, just the part time. Then searching one life purpose, another one, big life purpose. So big life purpose, no need to search that death, it is coming. Then finish. Real purpose is to understand the dharma. So in the Buddhism's quality is that if you really go through the Buddhism by taking the, you know, first refuge vows, the people is not like the ordinary people because they have some, you know, sensitive and they have some understanding of the 10 virtue and 10 non-virtues. So when they will play on this thing, then the people will see different. So like this, so by the understanding then going. So therefore, here we need, then after this, you know, we need the virtue, to increase virtue, then mandala. After this we can. So now there is the Vajrasattva. Vajrasattva practice. Now you finish the your mandala. Now you have enough virtue. Then you can check yourself. Now what is less in yourself? You become 100% Buddhism, and you become 100% Mahayana Buddhism, and you have the full, you know, capacity of the virtue. You have foundation. Virtue's foundation is you have. You offer the mandala, 100,000, you met this. Now what is with me? What I have to do now? Then you think, oh, up to now, if I will count, I can't count, you know, my past lives. Past life has no end, because Lord Buddha said, all living beings are once your mother. It means then, how many lives we took. So here only, we are here, you know, we will count. All you are once my mother, then 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, how many lives I took, you know. So there is also insect, many insects, flies. Then you are the son of that once. So you will count, then there is no counting. It is beyond the counting. So this much long time, we never got the enlightenment. And what I done all this time? So sometime I done little good things, then I born into the human And sometimes little good things, then demigod. Sometimes little good things, then God. Then again goes down. Then sometimes doing bad things, then going down. Again doing bad things, then going down. Only roaming this area and spend this much life. And now only we got the chance to getting through this, not roaming again. Complete liberation. Now try it. Complete try it. Rounding in the samsara. Now like to relax in the liberation stage. Then what is now? Now I have, virtue, fortune to do. There is, I am really man, Buddhism, Mahayana. Now what is wrong with me? Then such a long time, you have done many wrong things. Now there is many, you have the, credit, or what do you say? Yeah. Many obscuration is credit is left on you. Many lives, and especially from the birth to now, how many non-virtues you have done, and how many virtues you have done, and you've done much non-virtues, all these are there. So, now you have to clean up yourself this all, to purify, to pay back, so to clean. So how we will to clean this? Then we will think that we need some method to clean our obscurations. We are full of obscurations. So these sins, obscurations, so this to purify, this to clean. So this one is not going to clean by the shampoo, not going to clean by the soap. And not going to clean by the fire, by the elements, it is not going to clean. Now, how we have to clean this? Then this is the method. We have to do the visualization of the Vajrasattva. So to do the Vajrasattva, then we have, like the each session you are doing the refuge tree and then dissolving into you. So first when you will, first session time, you are doing, this is the object for whom I do the homage. For whom I pay the my, devotion. Then Bodhicitta's time, this is the object that that is the my witness. Then after this offering mandala, this is the object for whom I am giving, paying this. So all this, then each session, then going to dissolve into you. You have to dissolution. So you dissolve. So that time, now you have to do the front visualization of the Vajrasattva. So Vajrasattva is a photo. Here. So you people know the Vajrasattva. You should check that, in the Vajrasattva's photo looking. Then you will know how to do the visualization. So, first, there in the text, then it will say, turn the hum incidentally into the, Vajrasattva. Then how it will go. So front visualization, many tantric texts is coming. You do the front visualization, you do the self visualization. There is only two things. So many people think front visualization means here, this side. So then they need the top visualization, down visualization, backside visualization, left visualization, right visualization, no mentioned in any text. So why not mentioned means visualization is doing by the you know, wisdom, mind, from the mind, you say, imagination is doing from the mind, visualization, pure visualization is coming through the, you know, wisdom. So, the wisdom, it has no direction, no ten direction. So then, all the texts you will be finding, do the front visualization, means this is also front. This is also front. This is also front. Other than you is front. Then self-visualization means that for which you are thinking me. So you are thinking me is then where our this, you know, curve is. Our curve is there, then we are thinking me is here. Not there, here. So that is the self. Then self-visualization to turn this curve, change. But incidentally, this curve is not going to changing into the, you know, any deities. But doing many practice visualization like this, then the your aura body is working first. When you will be sitting on your seat and meditation cushion and doing the visualization of Yishi Chojal is not sitting. She is standing. And you wrapped with all the shawl and cloth. She is no cloth. She is naked, standing. And to turn her means then you have to up all the cloth and stand up. That is not. So, in the first imagination that your aura body is standing. So aura body, it is not other than the your this body. This body is not other than the aura body. So aura body, we have aura body, but this aura body, then we can't see. We will see that aura body is seen by the Nagas. Nagas, they will see the human being's aura body. Every human being's aura body is seen. When people dying, that dying time, then finally, then it is going to, you know, fade, fading. Just a fading is going not so perfect. Then slowly, then that man is going to finish. Complete death, then there is no aura. Until people have the aura, then this life, then there is aura all around the body. So therefore, when we will do the front visualization of Vajrasattva on your Kurun Chakra, then Kurun Chakra, Vajrasattva is on your Kurun Chakra, means not like this, just touching here, not like this. At least we can put this much distance from here, above the our aura head. Aura head. So there is the, you know, Vajrasattva. We are saying just above your crown chakra, then there is the lotus. Then on the lotus, then there is the moon. Then on the moon, then there is the, you know, if you will do, then there is the hum. You can do the hum visualization. One seed syllable hum. White hum is there. So you give the your mind focus there and do this. And then instantly that hum is changed. Is changed into the Vajrasattva. So Vajrasattva is sitting there. So during this visualization, then you say Chivor, Jivar means above your crown chakra. Then Lama means your root guru. Dorsem form is a Vajrasattva, and nature is your root guru. And root guru and the Dorje Semba, there is no two, is become two in one, here may be. Then from there, you know, then nectar comes and enter into you. Kule dhizi jimbab dhibjang gyur. So here it says very short, but you have to do the visualization that above your crown chakra, then there is the white lotus. So lotus is also the stem, lotus stem. Lotus stem is in the middle here. And then you are in the, you know, straight body, and you are also the center channel. Center channel, then this top is a little open one, big. Then it goes small, thin up to here, near your this navel chakra. Navel chakra, then you put the, you know, four fingers from the navel, this drone side. This drone side, then other, there is two channels, red and white channels. These two channels is joined there and closed there. So up to this, then this, you think your center channel is right there, you know. Just one side is small and then little big, and it came up to here. So right there, then there is the, you know, lotus stem is there, and then the lotus is there. On lotus, then there is the moon. Then on the moon, then there is the Hung letter. And Hung letter is just, you know, changed into the Vajrasattva. So Vajrasattva is there. And then in the heart chakra of the Vajrasattva, then you think there is one Vajra. Vajra, you know the bell Vajra. Vajra. There is Vajra, and Vajra's joint like this, So just middle of the Vajra's joint. So there is also Hung. That Hung before it turned into the Dorje Semba, Vajrasattva. So like this white Hung, thin and white and very light one. Very, you know, bright one, Hung, small Hung is there, white Hung, giving too much light. So then you start to chanting, that is also white, like the Mercury's, like that. And then you start to chanting, Om Vajrasattva Samaya Manupalaya Vajrasattva Tinova, just going, this is the Vajra, then going like from here, it is starts, then it will go clockwise. Like this. Then mantra you chant and you set up the mantra's letters, 100 letters, and spanning always. It's just you are chanting, then it is just spanning, you are chanting continuously, spanning, and then giving much light, white light. And then it will come, all the, you know, very bright light. And then you think there is, you know, like the two ways. So that I think this is good way. Then you think that light comes, you know, out and then went all the 10 direction, this light, white light. And touching for all the 10 directions, Buddha, Bodhisattvas, pure lands, whatever good thoughts coming in your mind. Mother Tara's palace, Padmasambhava's copper mountain palace. So whatever you think good, for the 10 directions, touched this light and went upper. For offering for the, all the, you know, Shingdam, Kudam. It says, you know, all the mandalas, palace, and then the deities. When this light touched, it went for the offering. Then again this dissolve, again bring back. Then full energy or the blessing, blessing and energy of the 10 direction Buddhas, then dissolve to the mantra, and then again into the hum. Then hum is become more light, more energy, more light, more clear. Then also this mantra is surrounding. Then mantras all are rounding, circling, and then this become very light, and then this light goes into the nectar. Light is become all like the liquid. So all are the liquid, all liquid are just falling all over the, you know, inside the body of the Vajrasattva. Vajrasattva is become full of the nectar, and then it leaks the from his all the body portion, then licking the nectar out. So it is coming on the moon. Then from the moon, then it comes on the lotus. Then from the lotus, this, you know, stream. Then it comes first, tip, 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 tip. Then afterwards, then continuously, then coming. Then it is just touching in the your, this, you know, crown chakras. First stage is Kurun Chakra, there is, So it comes here, then all the Kurun Chakra is just, you know, washing by this nectar. Then nectar is continuously coming. Then washing all, then it will go down, Then throat chakra, and then all the other channels which joined there, everything is filling and washing. Then all the, you know, obscurations, all the sins, obscurations, negative energies, everything is become like the smoky color, dirty and water, like this water. So it is just coming down, and it started to leaking from all the your portion. Downside, it came all, and then it went underground like this by the pushing and washing. So after it become all the, you know, done, then it went to wash all over. Then again it is just coming, and it is making full nectar. For all your body is full nectar, as the, you know, empty bottle we fill up the milk like this. So until coming up to here, it is just overlooking like this thing, then you have to do the meditation about this. When it is come up to here, complete, full nectar is there. You are become also complete white. And who is sitting above your crown, that is also white color. So when it come there, then you will do this meditation, and you have to recite the mantra as much as, then again you can try again yourself is ordinary, and then washing and just filling the whole dish, and then again you wash, then again filling up to there, then again wash, you will do this bebjong means that again and again you try to wash yourself, washing yourself. Then you like to end the session, then you just give your mental focus and looking for this, you know, for the Vajrasattva. And then Vajrasattva is also very happy and smelling, face showing, and then saying, "Oh, great son, now all your obscuration is washed out. Now you become pure." He's saying this and very happy, and then he is become also nectar and dissolved into your center channel and entered into you. Then when it is dissolved into you, then you have to sit on that stage. So there is, you know, when complete dissolve, that is also one moment. One moment is coming, huh? So one moment when he dissolve complete into you, you and that, you know, your visualization is become two in one. So that stage, then you sit the meditation as long as you could. So as long as you could, meaning is that, when your this very crazy mind will bringing some thoughts, then you are not need to sit. So many people are thinking, as much as long you sit, you do the meditation, then they are just in, they dislike to sit, they are just pain and difficulty, even then sitting. That is meditation. That is not meditation. Until your body is in the meditation posture and mind is also on the right meditation, then you sit. Then your mind went, then leave it. Then, even then sitting there, thinking mind out, then that is not useful. That is just, you know, nothingness. So do like this. Yeah. Then any question about this? So yesterday you were saying Dharmakaya, Sambhogakaya, Nirmanakaya. So what are you not? And what you got understanding? No, Dharmakaya, Sambhogakaya, Nimanakaya, you people say Nimanakaya.
Yes, the meaning.
Yeah. So how is Nimanakaya?
Yes.
You got understanding?
No.
Then yesterday Gelong, you both are saying, yes. You got understanding? Yes. Then today say no. Okay, again, then not drawn. Huh? What is it? You know, you people know that, you know, nine objects of the refuge now, Buddha, Dharma, Sangha, that you know, clear. Then Guru, Deva, Rakini, that also know. Guru means leg bone, Vajra. Then Deva means Vajrakilaya. Then Rakini means Ishi Sojal. In the Dunjom lineage, it goes like that. So these three is the three root you know. Then now there is, you know, Dharmakaya, Sambhogakaya, Nirmanakaya. So just in the rap, then we will say Dharmakaya is Samantabhadra. The Buddha with the consort, will be like Buddha with the white concert. That is the symbol of the Dharmakaya. Then Sambhogakaya, all these, Dorje Sambha, there is the five Buddha families with the concert. That is Sambhogakaya's symbol. Then Nirmanakaya is, you know, Buddha. All these Buddhas are the Nirmanakaya, who have the, you know, 32 major marks. And then also there is, you know, 80 minor marks, all these who have the double head, Buddha has. And ears are long up to here. So when he sit like this, then he is putting hand here, then it is not like this. It is touching there, and this is also touching here. So, like this thing. So there's a special one. This one is very difficult to get. That is called Zupu. There's white here. Buddha has one right here. There is, you know, something is seen, no? Buddha has there something. There is one right here. So you will take this and you do the measurement. It is this much long. When you leave it, it will go and it will sit here. Like the conch shell's head. It will sit like this, this. This is here. That is called Nzupu. And like the wheel arts, there is the wheel in the hand, palm, and this here, also feet, like this, all the manner and measure marks. Who have this, that is called Nimanakaya, Tulgu. So nowadays, then Tulgu, all Tulgu is become modern. Then we don't know how we will count the measure or manner marks. Tulgu is like this, just that is the symbol. Then the real meaning of the Dharmakaya. Dharmakaya is the your pre-modal mind. So we are not a wisdom one. We have no capacity to see our pre-modal mind. When we will do the practice and we will getting to know, we will getting the realizing of the pre-modal mind, then there is no description. So just to recognizing this way, then you can say the object of mind. Object of mind is nothingness. We never finding the mind. Where is mind? What is mind? Mind is there, but we never find the mind. So object of mind is emptiness. So that is Dharmakaya. The nature of mind is very bright. We will go through the mind, then we will understanding the three kayas. So object of the mind is emptiness. That is Dharmakaya. The nature of mind is very bright, light or bright. Very bright, that is Sambhogakaya. The emptiness and bright is full of compassion. That is Nimanakaya. So therefore then compassion is the seed of the enlightenment. Why we are saying means that. So we have compassion, but compassion is become partiality and a small one. then that time, this is the fool. Now little understanding, what is that, you know. What is Dharmakaya means the object of the, you know, mind itself is emptiness. So that is called the Dharmakaya. Then you say the nature of mind is very bright, light, very crystal or light or bright. That is Sambhogakaya. Then this emptiness bread is full, you know, full of the compassion. That is the Nimanakaya. Okay, like that you can say. Then, any other question?
I think last time in relationship to these three kinds that you mentioned something about the Dharmakaya being the powerhouse.
No, that is just, you know, I'm giving you example.
Yeah.
So, Dharmakaya is like the powerhouse.
Yeah.
So manifesting of light is like the Sambhogakaya. Then usefulness of this light is the Nimanakaya. That gives a little, you know, understanding. That is example. In the real text, you are not going to find that powerhouse or something. You're not going to find it. But I'm trying to understand. Maybe Buddha term and Pema Sambhava term, there is no powerhouse, no light. Okay. Then, any other questions?
No, the steps of the Nandro practice, they are done in that specific order. You complete all the prostrations before you
get step by step. That is good. Because this, you know, there is meaning, you know. First one prostration is why. Means you are making 100% yourself is Buddhism. You have 100,000 prostration, 100,000, you know, refuge, that prayer you speak and you will recite. So real you will become the 100% Buddhism. So second one is, only become Buddhism is no use for you. Is Hinayana, Mahayana, no different now, just Buddhism. So to enter into the Mahayana Buddhism, then you done the, you know, bodhicittas. You really working for the other, not self. So that 100,000, then you become really into the, you know, Mahayana. Buddhism, Mahayana. Then you are thinking, you know, now what is the shortage in me? So virtue is little less. So I need the virtue to hold the, all the dharma practice, to not have the, you know, obstacles. I need the virtue. So then mandala. Now I have virtue. Now what is shortage in me? Then you have to, you know, there is many, you know, obscurations, past life's obscuration, this life's obscuration. You have many obscurations. So to wash this, to finish up this. So this washed, now you have, you know, you are pure. Nothing karmic debt is left. You washed all. And you have enough, you know, virtue. You are pure Buddhism and Mahayana Buddhism. So what do you need? Now need the main practice. Main practice is to become equal to your master. Who is your master? My master is content of the triple gems, three roots, three kayas. All quality is here in one. So I like to become this. So then you are trying to mix up, to become two in one. So that is the, you know, final Guru Yoga. So some place here, I don't know that there, maybe there is some way. So I'm going to do like this through as the Jutaiji Dorje, Dunjom Rinpoche, he, when he, you know, teach this for me, and when I done according to this, so it's step by step. That is important, as Rinpoche say. So now there, you know, some place, so Jangdu Rinpoche student like this, maybe there is some way, I don't know, Rinpoche told that, you know, they are doing first Guru Yoga, something like this. So I think that, you know, if you don't do the refuge 100,000 past, then you are not a 100% Buddhism. And you don't do this one, you know, bodhicitta's course, then you are not, you have no capacity to say that, you know, authority to say I am Mahayana Buddhism. Then you are not perfect Buddhism, not perfect Mahayana Buddhism. Then how you will do the, you know, Guru Yoga first? First, you have not on the switch of your oven and not put in the, you know, pot and not put in the water. How you will cook the tea? How you will enjoy tea first? First, enjoying tea, then going, putting the, buying the, you know, substances to make the tea. First, drink tea, then go to the shopping, buy the sugar, milk, these things. Then bring then bring the pot. Then bring the oven. Then is it possible? First we have to place the fire pot and then substances, then you cook, then you drink the tea. So before buying the substances, you enjoy the tea. Then it's not happening, I think. So therefore, it's step by step. That is the main text. This is the, you know, as Padmasambhava wrote, Padmasambhava taught. And like this way, and this is also came up to now. From the 7th century, it started, then for a while it has hidden in the treasure, then after it came, so up to now it is using, this is the right way. So we should try to go through the, you know, right way. Then, any other question? No.
At the beginning, when you were talking about the bodhicitta, and you were talking that petting the dog isn't the real compassion that we're looking for, it seems a lot of times the ego gets very, very happy of doing compassionate acts and tries to make a big show. That I do so many compassionate acts, I will surely become a Buddha because everyone will see me doing these compassionate acts. But that doesn't seem right. How should a bodhisattva train to keep the bodhicitta pure and not fall into the dualism? Trying to make a show of compassion for all the mother sentient beings.
Sure, compassion. Sure, compassion, you have to increase the, you know, your own compassion. You have the compassion, you know. You notice that there is compassion in you? There is compassion in you. You like your parent. You like your child. You are giving full, you know, what do you say, duty to care that. Then to increase this one, you can care, that one, you can care to the other living being, same as that, try to care. And you are not care, and you are not serving your child to become famous. So if I will care my child too much, so the people will giving me some, you know, fame. You are not for purpose of this. If I will serve this child, you know, then there will be a, you know, some benefit is getting me. No. You are not hungry for the benefit to serving your child. You are not hungry for the fame to serving your child. Then same case you try to put on the other living beings. So to putting on the other living beings, then you like to have, instead of that, then you like to have the fame, then it means your mind, that is not pure. That has something wrong. So then Dharma movement goes into the action. If Dharma movement went into the only action, then people never getting the enlightenment. So they started to wearing monk dress and then just shaving here and just very simple, acting simple. But that is not enough. What you act, you must act according to your capacity, and you talk that which you know. Don't depend some others talk and give the message and run away. No, you should do yourself experience, and you know really, you feel, you have that experience, then you can talk. Really, I happened like this. It is happening like this. Then that is the truth. So when you are doing the, you know, some generosity, then it's also the Trilen Nurbu, he says, you know, for doing the generosity, you should be very careful. Otherwise, this generosity, you know, doing generosity, then it is getting some, you know, virtue for you. But instead of virtue, you are collecting big non-virtue, he says. Once he is teaching some Dzogchen teachings in Kathmandu, there is more than 700 peoples. And he says, oh, now you peoples are very careful. I am seeing there is one wrong, you peoples. One people is doing some, you know, color for the stupa, big stupa. Colors, you know, sponsor. Then other is saying, oh, he done this, I must do. I will pay more and I will do nice, more nice. And then Dalai Lama, like this, they are offering the mandala. How much he paid for the Dalai Lama? How much he offered? He offered 1,000. I must offer, you know, 2,000. So I will become great. So if you do like this, you know, then that generosity or the offering, whatever you done is just went into the jealous or the competition. So that motivation is wrong. Therefore, there is no result, anything. So like this, you know. So we should share our compassion, that not a duplicate compassion. Just out is very, very showing, very, you know, compassion. But mind is very not as act. So that is duplicate. Whatever you think, you know, if you will share your compassion, then share as like your child. For the child, you are doing your love, you are giving love. That is not for the fame, that is not for the wealth. So same as that, you can share the other people compassion. Don't think that I will taking something, I will getting something from there. If you will do the compassion with thinking that compassion is not true compassion. That is just business, something give, something take. Something give, don't care about this. You only care is must have benefit that man, that living being, for whom you give the, you know, help, give the, you know, compassion, whatever you show, that is, you know, must help them complete. And don't think that what I am happening, then it is wrong. If you will wait for this result, something is coming. Then it is going less. It is going wrong. Yeah. Yeah.
How is that different than doing practice because you want to gain merit? If you do practice because you want to gain merit, is this the same thing?
Merit.
Merit.
You are saying merit. Merit itself is nothing. You are making your capacity. Doing practice is making capacity. Because less capacity, then trying to making capacity. And then there is, you know, if you go in further in the Dzogchen, many thinkings, then you will find there is no bag where you have collect the merit. And there is no bag where you collect the sins, virtue, sins. No bag. But there is. So? So making the understanding's capacity, preparation, preparing. If the nectar falls, then I must hold, then I need the pot first, you know. So like this, to making, that is called the virtue, to not harming other. So Buddha's all teaching you collected together then is become harmless. Harmless stage is the Buddha's teaching. All teaching Dharma is collected is that. Harmless, then helpful. Harmless means helpful, harmless. If there is harm, like the, you know, doing sacrificing offering, to kill the something and you offer to pacifying the deities. So that is, you know, Buddha, why it is say wrong means it is harming to the others. One's life is harming and the other is just pacifying. So then he says that is wrong. So his view is harmless. No harm. So all the practice is trying to not harm other. So Buddha's root teaching itself is, you know, 10 virtue, 10 non-virtue, he said that. So if you have no devotion in the Buddha, even then you try to act according to the 10 virtue, so you are become excellent man in this area. Who he is, you know, like the not telling lie, always telling truth. So, who he is, that we are saying, first is Jun Tama, who he is not making the divisive speech. Then, who he is never saying a harsh word. Then who he is not hanging unnecessary talk, then this man is excellent. If he don't think about the virtue, but he act as like that, that man is quality is different. So who he is not killing anybody, so that man is very excellent. No killing. Then, so who he is not stealing others' belonging, then very good man. Then by knowing this, you know, virtue and taking the promise and tying yourself into the Buddhism, so that has the more benefit. By knowing doing and without knowing doing, that has much different. So therefore, then we are taking the refuge vow, and then according to this, then we trying to do. So we, after taking the vow like this, then we feel, then we remember this again and again. So then, that what is the quality, then we will test this, and then we can enjoy this. Then if it is really true, then we can tell to the, our friends. So they can do also enjoy. So like these things, actually is harmless. Harmless is the, you know, harmless, full of kindness. This is called the real practice. But that is not coming. How much we will try, I must become the harmless. How much we will try, and sometime, cost, condition will touch and you turn immediately wrong way. So then, at that time, then we have, who have the, you know, experience and who really in the world, who took this, who done the little practice about this and who know the this right meaning, then they will take the, you know, right path at that time. When people will, you know, fighting you at that time, then we like the, we have to use the passion. So nobody is fighting you and nobody is harming you, then passion is useless. Then for whom you will use the passion? No people need the help, then your generosity has no work. You are not sick, then no need of medicine. So, then, any other question? 10 minutes, then it is okay. No, maybe. Okay, then tomorrow we will talk about the Guru Yoga. So real essence of the practice is coming in the Guru Yoga. Because Guru Yoga is the studying of the main practice. So up to this we went, you know, preliminary practice. So now Guru Yoga is like the this floor. So this is the base of the next floor. So therefore this is most important one. This has the this energy will going all the, you know, main practice up to the like the teacher, then teacher stage, then again this end is coming different level, touching, then it will sit out teacher, then teacher stopping, then it will go thakal, then thakal it is stop, then it will going vasal, then it is finished whole course from the preliminary practice to the vasal crystal light. Then become Kundu Sambo. So like this, yeah?